Hello students, so I would like to help you in finishing activity number one, which is plotting the bar. Kindly look into your screen. So on the right side of your screen, you have here the different points. Ito yung mga ipa-plot ninyo. And on the left side of your screen, you can see here map of the Philippines together with these grid lines. And it is where you are going to plot the points. Now you have here numbers here on the left side of the map. And actually, these ones indicate latitude. So, ang direction nito is north. So, ito yung north. And on the lower part of your map, you can see here yung numbers 115 to 135. These are indicating longitude or the direction is east. Letter E. Okay? Then you have here the different steps on how you would be plotting the bar. And that is what I will be teaching you with. Okay. So, on the next slide, na ipapakita ko sa inyo, dun natin gagawin yung plotting of bar. So, let me remove first the drawings. Okay. So, let's look into the different points that you are going to plot and together with the steps. So, step number one, it says here that you have to look into the first pair of coordinates. And in this case, our first pair of coordinates ay ito. Yan, si 5 degrees north and 115 degrees east. So, first is you have to locate 5 degrees north. So, ito si 5. And 115 degrees east or longitude. Okay? And then you have to find their point of intersection. So, kung saan magtatagpo yung mga lines na yan, pwede kayong mag-drawing ng broken lines or imaginary lines para lang mapagtagpo nyo yan. And then, dito rin sa 115. However, class, yung pinaka-point na ilalagay ninyo is kung saan lang ang kanilang intersection point. And in this case, kung saan nagtagpo yung first set of points, 115, doon yung ilalagay yung point. Yan, the green one. Okay? Then afterwards, you proceed with the next set of points. So, point B tayo, 15 degrees north. So, hanapin ulit si 15 degrees north. Ito, ang partner niya is si 115 degrees longitude or east. So, ito yung nasa baba pa rin. So, again, you will have to find their point of intersection. Okay? So, tignan natin kung saan mag-i-intersect yung dalawang points na yon. Okay? So, once again, 15 and 115. So, eto si 15. Ayan, nakikita ba? So, ayan, di ba? Ayan si 15. Tapos, eto si 115. So, gamitan ko ng ibang kulay ha. So, eto, 115. Ayan. So, kung saan silang dalawa magtatagpo, ayan, dito sila magtatagpo, class. Diba? Nakikita nyo, ito si 15. Tapos, dito mula sa baba, pakyat para ma-meet niya si 15. Yan. This is where you will be putting your point. The point of intersection, dyan nyo siya lalagyan ng malaking dot. Alright. So, once done, you proceed to the next set of points. So, you have 21 north and 120. So, dito naman kayo kay 21 daw at saka 120. So, you find 21. Ayan. So, actually, from 21, tumingin ka na lang sa baba para mahanap mo yung 120. So, ayan. Nakikita nyo yung pag-move ng pen. And, pag nahanap nyo na yung 120, saka ka mag-stop. Ayan. Tingin sa baba. That's 120. Tama? And, kung saan ka nag-stop, ibig sabihin, doon ang intersection ni 21 and 120. Then, dyan mo nalagyan ng dot. Yan, yung red one. Okay? So, once you are done, pag natapos mo na lahat to, halimbawa hanggang F, natapos mo na yan, what you will do next is to connect the lines. Connect the dots. Okay? Para, you will be getting your PARNA or the Philippine Area of Responsibility. So, gagawin lang is mula from point A hanggang kay point B. Yan, connect mo siya. Tapos mula naman kay B, papunta kay C. Yan, i-connect mo lang. Okay? So, So, tatapusin mo lang yan. And eventually, you will form here a solid figure or an enclosed figure. And that is your Philippine area of responsibility.